Hello students, in today's lecture we will see next topic from the second chapter, range extension of ammeter. So the first topic is that what is the necessity of range extension. So as we know that the ammeter coil has lighting weight and it can carry very small current up to the 100 milliampere. If high values current to be measured, this coil cannot be directly connected to the circuit. So there is the necessity of the range extension. Therefore, this ammeter can read or measure the high values of current. So how ammeter range is extended means what we can connect, then the ammeter can measure the high values of the current. So there is one instrument that is nothing but our shunt. By using this shunt we can extend the range of our ammeter. So what is meant by shunt? Shunt is nothing but a low resistance, and it is connected in parallel to the ammeter coil. Here in this diagram we can see this is nothing but our shunt. So this shunt is nothing but parallel resistance and it has low value. So we will see how range will get extended corresponding to the shunt. So as we know that in this diagram there will be ammeter coil. Here it is given the supply voltage to the ammeter. As we know that ammeter is connected in series with the load. So here we are connecting the load. This is nothing but resistance of ammeter coil. So it is denoted by RA. Through this coil our current is flowing, that is nothing but your current flowing through the ammeter coil. It is the current capital I, and that capital I is nothing but high current to be measured. We have to measure this current, high value of the current which is to be measured. Next, this is nothing but our shunt resistance, and this shunt resistance is nothing but we are connecting in parallel to the ammeter coil. So in this coil also current is flowing, and that is nothing but RSH. So it is the shunt current or the current flowing through the shunt. So with the help of this diagram, circuit diagram, we have to calculate the value of our shunt resistance. What is the value of our this shunt resistance? In how much resistance can be connecting parallel to the ammeter coil, then and then only the range of the ammeter will get extended. So we have to find out the values of our RSH, that is the shunt resistance. So here we had seen main parameters. First one is the supply voltage. Is the high value of current, it is to be measured. I is nothing but ammeter or the current flowing through the ammeter coil. The current flowing through the shunt resistance or the resistance of our shunt, and this is nothing but our resistance of ammeter coil. With the help of our these parameters we have to calculate the value of our shunt resistance. So RA is resistance of ammeter coil, RSH is the resistance of shunt in ohm, obviously both are in ohm, RA is the current flowing through ammeter, and capital I is nothing but high current to be measured, and the currents will be in ampere. So with the help of this circuit diagram we have to take the derivations. derivations for the RS edge. So voltage drop across the ammeter coil and voltage drop across the shunt, that will be equal due to these are connected in parallel. So the voltage across this ammeter coil, it will be equals to the voltage across this shunt resistance. So by this one, that is the voltage drop across the ammeter coil, it will be equals to voltage drop across the shunt. So therefore it will be equals to voltage drop, so therefore it will be equals to I into RA, and it will be equals to ISH into RASH. That means the voltage across this ammeter coil, it will be equals to I into RA, and the voltage across the shunt resistance or shunt coil, it will be equals to ISH into RSH. So here the equation will be IRA, it will be equals to ISH into RSH. So RSH, we have to calculate the value of this RSH. Therefore RSH, it is equals to IRA divided by RSH. But RSH, it is equals to, here we can see this RSH, it is equals to I minus IA, because I, it is equals to IA plus ISH. So ISH, it is equals to I minus IA. So here put the equation for the RSH. RSH, it is equals to I minus IA. RSH, it is equals to IRA upon I minus IA. So here take equation I minus IA, it is equals to IARA upon RSH. These terms will get interchanged. So divide by the IA to the both sides. For this equation, divide by IA. So it will be equals to I minus IA, I minus IA upon IA equals to IARA upon RSH into IA. So here we can see simply dividation and it will get cancelled. So IA upon IA, it will get cancelled. So corresponding to this one, remaining terms are I minus IA upon IA equals to RA upon RSH. So in the next step, what we have to do, this IA gets simplified for the both equation, both the terms. So this IA will divide it to the I also, and it will divide it be for the RA also. So I upon RA minus IA upon RA equals to RA upon RSH. So RA upon IA, it will be equals to 1. I upon RA minus 1 equals to RA upon RSH. Next, this minus 1 will get towards the right hand side, so it will be positive. Next, we have to put the I upon IA equals to M. Therefore, this I upon IA, it will be equals to M. M, it is equals to RA upon RSH plus 1. So this equation becomes this one. M equals to this one. So we can calculate M. So this RSH will get multiplied for the both sides. So M, it is equals to RA plus 1 into RSH, that is the RSH upon RSH. So again M into RSH, it will get multiplied to the M. M into RSH, it is equals to RA plus RSH. So this RSH will get at the left hand side, same terms will be at the one side. Therefore, M into RSH minus RSH, it is equals to RA. So, from this equation, RSH will get common, RSH into M minus 1 equals to RA, because from this equation, RSH will be common, M is remaining, and here only 1 is remaining, that is RSH will get common. So, the equation becomes RSH into M minus 1 equals to RA. So, we have to calculate the value of our RSH, that is the shunt resistance, and therefore this RSH, it is equals to RA upon M minus 1. So, this M minus 1 here is multiplication, so it will be here divided. So, RSH, it is equals to RA upon M minus 1, and we know that the M is nothing but I upon RA. Therefore, this RSH, it is equals to RA upon I upon RA minus 1. And this is nothing but our shunt resistance. So, what is mean by shunt? It is a resistance which has low value and it will be connected in parallel to the ammeter coil resistance. So, how much value can be connected across the ammeter coil, then and then only that ammeter can measures the high value of current. So, this is nothing but the range extension, and for the range extension, we can connect the shunt resistance. So, requirements of the shunt means what? The properties of our shunt. How much? What are the characteristics of the shunt? Then and then only our range extension will be more easier. So that shunt should be low temperature coefficient, or the our shunt, it should have low temperature coefficient. Second one, resistance should not vary with the time. As per time will get vary, the resistance value will not get changes. Next one is what? It should carry current without excessive temperature rise. If they are, according to the load, the excessive heat will get produces in the circuit, and corresponding to that one, it should have carry more current. It should have carry current without excessing in the temperature rise. And most important, that is nothing but our last one, the shunt should be the material of magnesium material. So, the material of the shunt, it will be magnesium for the DC ammeters and galvanometers, and for the AC ammeters, if we have to extend the range of our AC ammeters, the material of our shunt will be constant ton. As per this requirement, we have to select the shunt for the range extension. Okay. So, here we had extend the range of our ammeter by using this shunt resistance. Shunt resistance is the low value of resistance. It is connected in parallel to the ammeter coil, and its formula is nothing but RSH, it is equals to RA upon M minus 1. That is RSH equals to RA upon I upon RA minus 1, where RSH is the shunt resistance, RA is the resistance of ammeter coil, I is nothing but high value of current to be measured in the circuit, and IA, that is the current flowing through the ammeter coil. So, it is nothing but our shunt resistance. And this is used to extend the range of ammeter.